Welcome back to my channel. This is going to be the second in a three-part video sequence on solving systems of equation with Gaussian. In this video, we're going to assume the usage of a TI-84 calculator and include a demonstration of how to use that to speed this process along. So our first system that we're solving is x minus y plus 2z equals negative 3, 4x plus 4y minus 2z equals 1, and negative 2x plus 2y minus 4z equals 6. And using our calculator to put this into reduced row echelon form. Okay, so let's enter our matrix into the calculator. So we're going to go to the matrix menu. You hit second, then you hit above the X inverse key. And then we're going to tab over to the edit menu. I'm tabbing right. So hitting enter on matrix A, we're going to have to tell it the size of the matrix. We have 3 rows. We have 4 columns. And then we're going to enter in our entries left to right. So there's 1x, negative 1y. Make sure you're hitting the negative key down at the bottom instead of the subtraction key, which is up there. Then we have 2z. Then we have negative 3. Then we have 4x, 4y, negative 2z. And then we have 1 for our constant. Then we have negative 2 for our x, 2 for our y, negative 4 for our z, and 6 for the constant. And then we're going to quit back home. Done entering in that matrix. Now we're going to tell the calculator to put the matrix into reduced row echelon form. We go back to the matrix menu. We tab over to math. And we look down at option alpha B. You can either tab down to it or you can hit alpha B on your calculator if you want to save a couple seconds. Hitting enter. Now we need to tell the calculator which matrix we're going to do this on. So on the names tab, hit enter on matrix A, close the parentheses, and there's our reduced row echelon form in decimal form for pre-calculus, at least with me. I certainly request students to put everything into fractions because that makes your answer exact. Versus sometimes you're rounding and you don't really necessarily realize it. So to convert this to decimals, or sorry, to convert from decimals to fractions, we'll hit the math key. And then we'll hit enter on the frac key. Then we hit enter again. And there's our matrix in reduced row echelon form. Our REF is 1, 0, 3/4, negative 11 over 8. 0, 1, negative 5/4, 13 over 8, and the row that gives it away that this has infinite solutions is the last row, which consists of all zeros. What this means is that we have, because we have one row of all zeros, we have one independent variable, and it's in the third row, so that means our independent variable is z. And we're going to parameterize the solution set. Basically, what's happened is that our 3 points no longer intersect at a single point. In this case, it looks like because we have one independent variable, they're going to intersect on a line. Okay, so let's work on explaining what x and y are in terms of this parameter t. So looking at our first equation, we have that x plus 3/4 z is negative 11 over 8. So we solve for x just like we would any equation. And then because z is our parameter t, x is now negative 11 over 8 minus 3/4 t. Repeating this process for y, y minus 5/4 z is 13 over 8. So that means that y equals 13 over 8 plus 5/4 z, but z is our parameter t. And now we write our solution, and this is really a whole set of infinitely many solutions that together would look like a line. And there's our solution set. Okay, so let's check out another example. Moving on to our next example, we're going to solve the system
x minus 2y plus z equals negative 6, 2x minus 3y equals negative 7, and negative x plus 3y minus 3z equals 11. So the one thing to remember is make sure to note that we are missing a z here. So when you enter this into your calculator, you're going to want to make sure to enter a 0 in that position. We'll jump on over to the calculator.
For this matrix, I've already taken the liberty of entering the matrix into the matrix menu, so let's just get the reduced row echelon form on it. Going to the matrix menu, tabbing over to math, scrolling down to reduced row echelon form. And what matrix are we going to do that on? We'll do that on matrix B. And there we go.
And it looks like our reduced row echelon form is 1, 0, negative 3, 4, 0, 1, negative 2, 5, and our row of all zeros. So again, it looks like we have one independent variable. And that independent variable is z. So we'll let z equal t. And then we'll parameterize x and y in terms of t. So if x minus 3z equals 4, then x equals 4 plus 3z. So x equals 4 plus 3t. Similarly, if y minus 2z equals 5, then y equals 5 plus 2z. So y equals 5 plus 2t. And there's our solution set. Hopefully that was helpful. Stay tuned for part 3 when we go over how to solve systems with no solution.